while Joe Biden in that speech is sort of saying, I can work with the Republicans and all of that, that's not gonna stop a lot of Republicans, especially in the media, from claiming that that speech was something that I don't think it was. Here is a Fox News anchor talking about that speech. Take a look at her spin on it.
Joe Biden and his message of unity, not here, slamming President Trump for challenging the results of the election, why the president-elect might be hurting himself by attacking his predecessor. Plus.
Okay, like honestly, Joe Biden, I don't think has ever given a divisive speech, at least not if the thing that's being divided is Dems from Republicans. He's given speeches that are divisive from the point of view of a leftist. He's done divisive stuff there. But he is always waiting. Like he could reach out to the Republicans, have his hand cut off, and he'd just reach the stump farther. Like he always is trying to unify with them. And yet for Fox News, it's never gonna be enough.
I mean, the reality of it that people have to realize is that you have a media outlet based on grifting, right? And right now they're losing most of their base because their main star, Donald Trump, no longer wants people to support them. So now I think what they're doing is they're trying to be divisive so that they can get some of the Trump supporters back, right? Saying, oh, look at the system, look at Biden, they're attacking Trump. So some of those Trump supporters will come back and give viewership to Fox. But realistically, they're blowing smoke. Biden said nothing divisive in that speech. In fact, I thought that he could have been a little bit more divisive and called some things out.
Yeah, I mean, look, divisive can come in a couple different forms, but I would love to see the Democrats act like they won. And I don't just mean acknowledging that they won. I mean, acting like you won by millions of votes, that the country has rejected the other party, that they actually want you to do something. Democrats in victory or in defeat are always like, well, you know, maybe some people like us, but let's not go crazy. Let's not, like, you know, kick up any dust or anything. Like you won, man, you won and you keep winning. We won in 2018 a bunch. We got more votes in 2016, like act like it. But it's not just Fox. Oh, and by the way, I'm not good with faces in media. Was that Martha McCollum? Do you actually know? I believe it was.
I have no clue. No,
I'm not sure.
Yeah, I try not to pay any mind to too many of them, to be honest.
That's true. Let's, for the sake of conversation, let's say that it was Martha McCollum. So I agree that she, and if not, Martha will do this at some point today, is trying to reappeal to those Republicans that have turned against them, in no small part because Donald Trump is doing everything he can every day to turn them against. I think that's, no, I don't think it's Martha McCollum, but anyway, point stands, whatever. I read in an Axios piece that Trump, says someone was talking to Trump, Trump was talking to someone about some random thing, and he stopped the conversation to bring up that some chucklehead on Newsmax had beaten Martha McCollum in the ratings the day before. Because he hates Martha McCollum now, because she like acknowledged that Trump, like that is a level of pettiness, being concerned about Fox daytime ratings, like that you think you're gonna like win him back or his fans back just by calling Biden divisive. You're gonna have to do a lot more. It's gonna take you to some dark places to get those people back on your side.
Yeah, I think that by the end of maybe February, Fox News goes complete owned. I think 100%. There is at this point no other way because people are leaving, right? They're leaving in hordes, and you know, for Fox, Fox has to go to a level that even Tucker Carlson would have to be like, you know, which is a rare thing. Mm-hmm. I don't think Tucker Carlson has ever to. Turned his back on any white supremacy, but
yeah, and but I think that might be Sandra Smith actually. Anyway, but not important. They're not the only ones who are calling it divisive. Kayleigh McEnany tweeted, "Joe Biden should not ever utter the words unprecedented assault on democracy. This was an assault on democracy," and she lists a bunch of the things they're obsessed with. "This is a divisive speech." Of course, her tweet was actually considered divisive by Twitter, so it was flagged as such. But yeah, Joe Biden, like he spent the entire primary like trying to affiliate himself in the minds of the voters with Barack Obama as much as possible. And I think he should get ready to experience one bit of Barack Obama's life, which is spending 4 years trying to appeal to Republicans and finding out that they're gonna attack you at every turn. At least this branch of the Republican Party, I don't think they're gonna be buying it anytime soon.
Which I think is a big mistake. He's gonna inherently do that. But like you said, Democrats have to start acting like they won, right? Like they won big this election, like they won big in the midterms. But I just don't think that the party is built that way. There's this oh gosh golly thing to the Democratic Party. And, yeah. And sometimes, frankly, it feels as though the Republicans strategically in terms of communication and letting their, even when they lose, they act like they won. Like, you know, we win and we can't act like we won. So, and that's something that I think needs to change immediately, because we're gonna have a hard four years with a lot of gaslighting and a lot of false narratives about this election.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.